I need someone. John, do you want to help me?
Yeah.
Let's say now the fence, yeah, is something that I put between me and the threat, okay? So if somebody is coming towards me and I didn't see him and he arrives me, and I'm like, oh, how you doing, mate? You alright? See what I did? I kind of put my arm here because I don't want to allow him in that space. Because from here, anything could go and it's going to come out of my peripheral field of vision. Yeah? So there are different types of... who can tell me where your personal space starts? Anyone?
Long range.
Which?
I'd say long range.
Arms length.
Yeah, arms length.
Longer than that. Like,
you see that? We got a few kickboxers here. He just said leverage because you like to push people with your kicks as well. I love to do that as well. As soon as he's here, he's in my personal space. Boom, we can kick him in the balls. Yeah? But I can't punch him. To punch him, I have to use my footwork now and get him. Yeah? So he's already in my personal space here. But most people speak from a conversational range is here. Yeah? Arm length. Yeah? So who said arm length before? Yeah? Yes. Conversational range, it's fine. Yeah? So now if he tries and punch me, yeah, punch and let us, even if I get caught, yeah, that might still knock me out. But if I'm here and now he punches me and go all the way, that's gonna fucking knock me out. You agree? Yeah? So what I wanna do is have some type of situational control. Have my hands halfway up in a non-aggressive manner. So I'm not doing this, because if I'm doing this, and there are a lot of CCTVs, we're in the UK here, you wanna look like the good guy. And you wanna have witnesses on your side all the time. Because after when the police arrive, if you have to damage the guy, unfortunately you don't want to, but if you have to, yeah, and the police arrives, you're gonna have to explain to them what you did, how you did it, why you did it, how it made you feel, how the initial threat made you feel, and you know, how it affected what your
plus
reaction.
Plus I suppose it sets his level up a notch, doesn't it?
Say again.
I say it'll set John's level up if you...
Of course, so yeah. Because
like,
you
right,
want to try to diffuse the situation.
Yeah.
So just really quickly going through the game plan, yeah? The competitive game plan is situational awareness, situational control, what I'm trying to explain to you now, and you know, it's always situational control can be trying to diffuse the situation. Avoid and escape is always a priority. If you can't avoid and escape, you're going to try to de-escalate, diffuse the situation any way possible, any mean necessary, yeah? Now, if you can't diffuse the situation, you have to do something before he does something to you, which is preemption, okay? By the law, even the UK law, if you have a honest belief that your life or your health is in immediate danger, for example, if somebody's in front of you and goes like, I'm gonna fucking punch you, and goes like that, well, you got the right to fucking punch him as he is like that. If you know, if you train to do that, you got the right to punch him because you have it will be justified and justifiable and necessary. Yeah. So now the fence. Yeah, there are different types of fence. If you work the doors, yeah, you know that you get people like that, boom, so they can attack from here, or they can be like that here, boom, so they can attack from there. Yeah, there are different types of fence. There are long, high fence, which are more active when the guy already knows that there is a problem and now you're telling him to stay away. That's a long fence, yeah? Then usually you reinforce verbally. Fucking stay back, don't come near me, yeah? And then you got a low fence, you know, which is where it starts, yeah? So you're here and you're talking with the guy and you have to get used in front of the mirror to talk with your hands, like Italians, yeah? yeah, but that's what it is. But listen, mate, I don't know what the problem is, yeah? But I'm sure we can talk about it. And then from there you can strike, non-telegraphically, without even letting him know that you were ready to strike, yeah? Or you could be there, and just 1 second, John, take that pad, any pad, yeah? If you take that pad and just throw me a big shot as hard as you can, yeah? So I could be here talking to me. I don't know that when you want, when you, and I can be here. So from there, it's really easy for me to cover up. Now, if my hands are down and my feet are square, it's gonna take me all that time to bring my hands up before I can cover up, yeah? So I don't wanna do that, yeah? What I wanna do is have my hands halfway up so that I can react to what he does, yeah? At the same time, I can talk to him, I can keep him away, and I can have a tactile antenna. Every time he touches my fence, you know this type of, put your fence up, every time that guy's like, what the fuck are you touching me for? Well, that's like a tactile antenna. I know where he is, even if my eyes are closed, I know where he is, yeah? It's the same principle in boxing as ranging your punch with that jab, yeah? Same thing, same principle. But we do it from a non-aggressive platform, because witnesses, CCTV cameras. I want to look like the good guy who's trying to defuse the situation. Listen, mate, calm yourself down, mate. I don't want no problem with you, yeah? Calm yourself down. And then from there, I got my hands here. But what's the difference between this and this? There's not much difference, yeah? Only open hands equal open communication. Closed hands equal closed communication, okay? You all right, Carlos? Right, so hands halfway up, yeah, to give me the time from there to spot him in the eye, to strike, to cover up, and to do all that stuff, yeah. So this is a fence.